Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Wednesday local time, after a bunch of delays in the weeks prior, SpaceX finally launched the crew-free mission to the ISS.
Zero. Ignition. And liftoff. God. Free.
The booster which launched, B1067, then landed successfully for the second time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas. Around 24 hours later, the crew-free astronauts arrived at the International Space Station. NASA posted this tweet saying 4 new astronauts through the hatch and 7 crew members total on the space station. After almost exactly a day from launch, Crew 3 is aboard the orbiting laboratory. A couple of days later on Friday, SpaceX launched yet another mission with another batch of Starlink satellites.
1. Liftoff.
The booster which launched that mission, B1062, then landed successfully for the 4th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions. There is a new Starlink terminal that's very square compared to the old one, and somebody posted a picture on Twitter. Musk responded and said, "Pattern on the Starlink router is orbital transfer ellipse from Earth to Mars." Somebody posted a tweet with an infographic about the Starlink launch. Musk responded and said, "Inter-satellite laser communications means Starlink can carry data at speed of light in vacuum all around Earth before touching ground. Over time, some amount of communication can simply be from one user terminal to another without touching the internet." There was then a tweet posted saying, "My parents are about to travel the Earth by boat and it would be great if they could use Starlink for their voyage." Musk responded and said, "Should work everywhere for global maritime by roughly middle of next year, enough sats with laser links launched. Until then it will be patchy when far from land." Over in Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch mountain tower. Here's a view of the rapid progress on the new wide bay building. Here you can see the staircase sections in the high bay. There was an article posted by The Verge about NASA's target date for the Artemis lunar landings. It says NASA is pushing back its target date for returning humans to the moon, now eyeing a crewed lunar landing in 2025 instead of 2024 as originally planned. Thought I would share this information about an event in which Elon Musk will be talking about Starship. It will be happening on November 17th between 6 p.m. and 6:30 p.m. Eastern Time. During the course of the week, the Ship 20 vehicle was prepared for another static fire test. However, this time the static fire is with all 6 engines and was performed on Friday. Chris Burgin posted a tweet saying, "Static fire and wow. Ship 20 fires up with thrust this time for a multi-engine test at SpaceX Starbase." Musk responded with, "Good static fire with all 6 engines." SpaceX posted an amazing picture on Twitter with the caption, "First 6-engine static fire test of Starship." Here's the Starship 21 nose cone pieces stacked in the yard. The other part of Ship 21 in the mid bay will have body flaps installed soon. The barrel section here is for the aft section of the Starship 23 prototype. They moved the B2.1 test tank and the GSE-4 test tank to the launch site for some testing. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, there are a bunch of upcoming dates. The next closure is scheduled for Wednesday 17th this coming week, as well as Thursday 18th and Friday 19th. Plus, there are additional closures posted for Monday 22nd and Tuesday 23rd for some more testing. Super Heavy Booster 4 has continued to be worked on in preparation for its own testing. The Booster 5 construction progress is continuing in the high bay. The Super Heavy Booster 6 upper stack was recently sleeved in the yard. Crews are also working on the aft section for Booster 6 in the yard. As always, I have to say thanks to Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, who is out there all the time filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.